She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. There must be something about her features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. Hello, everybody. If you guys don't know, I am a transfer student at UNC Chapel Hill and I just finished my first semester. So I really wanted to make a video just kind of like reflecting on all of that, answering you guys' questions. Also, I just got back from North Carolina. I'm in Connecticut right now with my family and I like don't have my bedroom or anything, so that's why I'm in this car. So thank you for bearing with me. For those of you who don't know, I originally went to Mount Holyoke College in Massachusetts for my freshman and sophomore year. Sophomore year like basically didn't happen because of COVID, so I was just online. But it's a very small liberal arts college. I realized that they didn't have what I wanted and I just wanted to transfer. If you want to know more about that, watch this video right here because that will tell you all about why I wanted to transfer. This last semester has literally been the most crazy school semester of my life. Like, I had so many new experiences. I met so many amazing people. It was just literally insane and the best and most stressful semester ever, I think, for me. So the first time that I ever visited UNC, I think I didn't really tell you guys explicitly that I was doing it, but as soon as I stepped onto UNC's campus, I remember that I just knew this was where I was meant to go. I got this gut feeling. So that's a huge thing if you want to transfer or are thinking about it. If you can, like, physically go to the campus that you want to or, like, think you want to be at and just feel the energy, like, feel, like, what it feels like. I'm so happy I did that because as soon as I got there, I knew it's exactly where I wanted to be. That is a huge, like, tip if you guys are thinking of transferring. After that first time, like, being there, I decided that's like where I need to go. So I committed to UNC.
I'm going to be going to UNC Chapel Hill next year. Literally, I'm moving to North Carolina in the summer. Like, I'm freaking out.
And I had orientation, but it wasn't in person. Unfortunately, it was online.
Time is literally flying so fast. But today I actually have my UNC transfer student orientation.
I also made a video about that for you guys, just like the online orientation day. That just made me super excited and kind of confirmed that was a place I really wanted to be at. So next, it was kind of like transitioning into actually moving into my dorm and being on campus and campus life and all that. And I got a lot of questions about adjusting to how big UNC is versus my old school. So I went from a school with about like 3,000 students, I think, to 20,000 students. So that's a huge leap, but I'm so happy I did that because I absolutely love how big my school is because it has the resources that I want, it has the variation of classes that I want, it has the sports and the school spirit and school pride that I've always like wished for and never gotten before coming to UNC. So I moved into my empty dorm. I lived in an apartment style dorm. This is me moving into my dorm, which I cannot believe was only in August. And I was really nervous about living with three roommates. I think it worked out pretty well because we each had our own different rooms. And the only reason that we could really get that is because we were all upperclassmen. So I'm also very grateful for that. But there was some room drama, just like with housing. I got my assignment mixed up like three different times. I was basically guaranteed to be placed with the roommates that I selected. And I spent like months like texting people and finding people that I thought I would like work well with in terms of living situation because I've had some like really negative experiences in the past with roommates. I got all that finished. I was ready to go with these roommates that I was very excited to live with. And when I opened up my housing assignment, I got placed with three random people. So that was actually really stressful. I did cry about that like three times. Also, some fun dorm stories. We had some upstairs neighbors who were super loud. I couldn't sleep a couple nights, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. Also had just a bunch of random like weird things break in the apartment. Like Kay's bathroom, the walls like filled up with water. It was a little strange. So that's a little fun anecdote for you. Also, apparently Bryce Hall was on campus, which is so random, but like that's the kind of thing that would never happen at my old school. Like, not that I want it to, but like it was just like a funny little thing. Like, this would have never happened to me before. Also, I literally still don't know who Bryce Hall is. Please don't attack me. Also, because of like the on campus and just like the area that I was in, I was so happy that I transferred, because there's just like more to do. So I get to like walk around Franklin Street, go to different shops. I don't have a car, but I can still be independent. Another thing is I was like really scared to be 14 hours away from home. I'm from Vermont, and the idea of like flying to go to school is really alien to me. It's like a lot more normal now because I've done it for the last two breaks. It was just a lot, so that was definitely something stressful, but I think that the fact that I like where I am so much like compensates for that. I haven't been homesick at all. I think it's because I FaceTime my parents like basically every single day, or like four times a day. I have attachment issues, but it works. So I think that was another fear that I had about being far away. So I also got a lot of questions about meeting new people and the party scene and everything. And I was super nervous about transferring, like making friends. And this is something that I'm still kind of struggling with. I've met so many like literally incredible people, and I met so many other transfer students, which I didn't expect, and also a lot of people that have the same interests as me, who are interested in media and design and journalism, which I've never experienced in my life before coming to UNC. I think that like I met a lot of people, but personally for me it takes a long time for me to like really connect emotionally and like become close with people, even though I've been there for a semester, just because you're so busy, everything's constantly happening, you have class, and it's really hard to coordinate meeting up with people. I'm kind of with that in the transferring, and I think that's pretty normal if you're going to a big school. But I will say one of the biggest struggles that I've had this semester because I transferred is feeling like really lonely slash left out. Like, I've had so many breakdowns associated with that, and just because I feel like I'm at a different place in life than a lot of other people in terms of like what I think is important and what I'm interested in doing with my time. But then I feel like I get like FOMO about parties and people dating and doing like quote like normal college stuff, because I spend all of my time editing and creating and answering emails, which I love, don't get me wrong. But yeah, definitely cried on the phone to my mom about that, like, a ton. So, I had my first day of class. I did make a vlog about that too, of course, which was really nerve-wracking. I was so nervous to meet my teachers and to find everywhere that I need to go for class and everything, and to just make sure that I didn't, like, pass out or something on the first day. Like, I didn't really know what I thought was gonna happen, but I was scared. I would definitely suggest taking your time to acquaint yourself with the campus if you're transferring, or if you're a freshman, just like finding where your classes are so you're more comfortable. I was really glad that I did that. I was really surprised. Well, honestly, okay, I wasn't surprised. I knew it was gonna happen, but it was still a bit of a shock of how hard the classes were, how much work I had to do, and how like, you know, harsh the teachers were. My teachers were really lovely and like supportive, but they were really, really serious about teaching. UNC has a much more like intense academic environment than I've been in before, and you know, Mount Holyoke is like a selective school. They have hard academics too, but it's just UNC is on a completely different level. So I saw my grades drop a bunch just because the amount of effort I had to put in before to get an A plus is the same amount of effort I put in now to get a B plus. And that's just like how it is. I'm really proud of myself for not letting myself like freak out about that, because I realized that it's normal. Like, you know, they just have different expectations, and it's not that I'm not working as hard, because I'm working harder actually, and I know that, but I'm learning more. So the grade adjustment is real, especially if you transfer to a harder college or like more academically rigorous. Another thing is I was surprised by how small all of my classes were. This can't be said for every major, but it just kind of worked out like that for me, is that every single class that I had this past semester was the same size as the ones that I had at my super tiny college. The amount of studying that I had to do at UNC is way more. I have never studied so much in all of my days. It was a lot. So at this point in the semester, I went to my first football game, my first basketball game, all that amazing school spirit stuff. I just had the best time. You guys know me, I'm not a sports person, but I've always wanted to go to like and be a part of like a college sports game environment.
And I'm not even like into sports at all, but I found myself being like, gosh, like I just want to go to a big sports game where we're all like rooting for the same team. And
I absolutely loved my first football game ever. It made me so, so happy to be there. I felt so proud to be a part of UNC, and I don't think I cried, but I did get emotional. I was just so happy to be there, and I was like, that's my school. Like, I get to root for my school. Okay, I'm getting a little emotional. I need to stop. In terms of those kinds of experiences, I also got to go to New York City with some of my friends for the weekend, which is not really something I would have been able to do before just because of location and everything. So I went with my friend Bella and then also my friends Yevon and Logan. We had the most amazing time, and I was so grateful to like be with people who wanted to do that and would like go with me, and we all like wanted to do the same stuff. I just felt like so alive. I know that's like so cringy to say, but it just made me so happy to be there, and I just like felt like I was living my best life. So that was definitely a highlight of my semester that it wouldn't have happened if I didn't transfer. Also went to my first concert ever, which again wouldn't have happened because actually like North Carolina actually has concert venues. I know, crazy. I know these are like really specific things, but these are all experiences that I wouldn't have gotten to have if I hadn't transferred. And finally we had final exams, final projects, more academic stuff. And again, just to reiterate, like the amount of work you have to do in academics is crazy. I took 4 classes this semester, but basically every student on campus takes 5 classes, which I've never had before. So next semester, I'm taking 5 classes and I am so scared. But I do love the academics, and it's a lot of work. But I'm glad that I chose it because I would rather be here doing a lot of work than at a school where I didn't get to learn anything I wanted and didn't have the resources to do the things that I wanted to do with less work. But overall, I'm so, so happy to be at UNC. Transferring so far away from home at a school I've never been to before was probably the craziest decision that I've ever made in my life, but it's also one I'm most proud of and happiest with. Here's to an incredible spring semester where we do even more amazing stuff and have the best semester ever. And I can't wait to share all of it with you in my vlogs, so definitely subscribe. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. She's a Mona Lisa.